The Hawker Siddeley Harrier is a jet-powered attack aircraft designed and produced by the British aerospace company Hawker Siddeley. It was the first operational ground attack and reconnaissance aircraft with vertical short takeoff and landing VSTOL capabilities and the only truly successful VSTOL design of that era. It was the first of the Harrier series of aircraft, being developed directly from the Hawker Siddeley Kestrel prototype aircraft following the cancellation of a more advanced supersonic aircraft, the Hawker Siddeley P.1154. In the mid-1960s, the Harrier GR.1 and GR.3 variants were ordered by the British government for the Royal Air Force, RAF. The Harrier GR. 1 made its first flight on the 28th of December 1967 and entered RAF service in April 1967. During the 1970s, the United States opted to procure the aircraft as the AV-8A. It was operated by the US Marine Corps, USMC. In the 1970s, the British Aerospace Sea Harrier was developed from the Harrier for use by the Royal Navy, RN, on Invincible-class aircraft carriers. Both the Sea Harrier and the Harrier fought in the 1982 Falklands War, in which the aircraft proved to be crucial and versatile. The RN Sea Harriers provided fixed-wing air defence, while the RAF Harriers focused on ground attack missions in support of the advancing British land force. The Harrier was also extensively redesigned as the AV-8B Harrier Sir 2 and British Aerospace Harrier Sir 1 by the team of McDonnell Douglas and British Aerospace. During the late 1980s and 1990s, the first-generation aircraft were gradually replaced by the newer Harrier the 2s. In 1961, the United Kingdom, the United States and West Germany jointly agreed to purchase 9 aircraft developed from the P-1127 for the evaluation of the performance and potential of VSTOL aircraft. These aircraft were built by Hawker Siddeley and were designated Kestrel FGA. One by the UK. The Kestrel was strictly an evaluation aircraft, and to save money, the Pegasus 5 engine was not fully developed as intended, only having 15,000 pounds, 67 kN, of thrust instead of the projected 18,200 pounds, 81 kN. The tripartite evaluation squadron numbered 10 pilots, 4 each from the UK and US, and 2 from West Germany. The Kestrel's first flight took place on the 7th of March 1964. At the time of the development of the P-1127, Hawker and Bristol had also undertaken considerable development work on a supersonic version, the Hawker Siddeley P-1154, to meet a North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO, requirement issued for such an aircraft. The design used a single Bristol Siddeley BS-100 engine with 4 swivelling nozzles in a fashion similar to the P-1127 and required the use of plenum chamber burning, PCB, to achieve supersonic speeds. The P-1154 won the competition to meet the requirement against strong competition from other aircraft manufacturers such as Dassault Aviation's Mirage 33. The French government did not accept the decision and withdrew. The NATO requirement was cancelled shortly after in 1965. Following the collapse of the P-1154's development, the RAF began considering a simple upgrade of the existing subsonic Kestrel and issued requirement ASR 384 for a VSTOL ground attack jet. Hawker Siddeley received an order for 6 pre-production aircraft in 1965, designated P-1127, RAF, of which the first made its maiden flight on the 31st of August 1966. An order for 60 production aircraft, designated as Harrier GR-1, was received in early 1967. The aircraft was named after the Harrier, a small bird of prey. In the late 1960s, the British and American governments held talks on producing Harriers in the United States. Hawker Siddeley and McDonnell Douglas formed a partnership in 1969 in preparation for American production, but Congressman Mendel Rivers and the House Appropriations Committee held that it would be cheaper to produce the AV-8A on the pre-existing production lines in the United Kingdom. Hence, all AV-8A Harriers were purchased from Hawker Siddeley. Improved Harrier versions with better sensors and more powerful engines were developed in later years. The USMC received 102 AV-8A and 8TV-8A Harriers between 1971 and 1976. The Harrier was typically used as a ground attack aircraft, though its maneuverability also allows it to effectively engage other aircraft at short ranges. The Harrier is powered by a single Pegasus turbofan engine mounted in the fuselage. The engine is fitted with two air intakes and four vectoring nozzles for directing the thrust generated, two for the bypass flow and two for the jet exhaust. Several small reaction nozzles are also fitted in the nose, tail and wingtips for the purpose of balancing during vertical flight. It has two landing gear units on the fuselage and two outrigger landing gear units, one near each wingtip. The Harrier is equipped with four wing and three fuselage pylons for carrying a variety of weapons and external fuel tanks.